Okay. Now we are going to take up one more example. A hollow steel tube is to be used to carry an axial compressive load of 150 kN. The yield stress for steel is 20 Newton per m square and the factor of safety is 2. The following are the three class of tubes of external diameter 100 mm are available. The light is 3.5 mm thickness. The class of medium is 4.0 mm and heavy is 5 mm. Suggest the suitable section. So here he has given that the data what is given is the yield stress for a compressive load. So P is given. Compressive load P is given to be 150 kN. So that means you convert this into Newton. It is 150 into 10 to the power of 3 Newton. Then he has given the yield stress. So the yield stress is given to be 250 Newton per mm square. So the maximum yield stress which is given. So then he says the factor of safety. So since he has given the factor of safety, which is 2, so we need to find out the permissible yield stress. So then he has given the following three class of tubes of external diameter is given. So D0 is given to be 100 mm or above. So the thickness he has given to three different thickness is given. So we need to find out, we need to suggest on which this will going to be suited. So to do that, so first we will going to analyze what is the thickness he is talking about. So here we have a hollow steel tube. So we have an internal diameter and also we have an external diameter. So this is the external diameter. So this will going to have the DI, which is internal diameter. So this will going to be the D0, which is the external diameter. So this is the area of cross section of the hollow tube. So now he says he has given the D0, that is he has given, we have got 100 mm. Which is the not given. So what I need to find out is, we need to find out the DI. So if I want to find out the DI, so how to do that? So DI will be equal to D0 minus 2 times the thickness. So this is the one which we need to find out. So DI will be equal to D0 minus this side T and also this side T. So if you subtract these two, so then I will be able to get the internal diameter DI. So this is the one which we need to find out. So now first to do that, so first we will, since he has given the factor of safety, so we need to find out the permissible stress. So how to find out the permissible stress? The permissible stress sigma y is given to be permissible stress, which is sigma is given to be yield stress divided by the factor of safety. Yield stress divided by the factor of safety. So yield stress is given to be 250 Newton per mm square. So that will be 250 divided by factor of safety is 2. So the permissible stress sigma is given to be 125 Newton per mm square. Then also we know that sigma is given to be P by the area of cross section, where the load is given to be 150 kN. So here, since the stress is known, the permissible stress is known, so 125 will be equal to P is 150 into 10 to the power of 3 divided by the area of cross section, we are going to consider as E. Therefore, the area of cross section of the tube, which will be equal to A, which will be equal to 1200 mm. square. 1200 square. Now, for the hollow section of outer tube and inner tube, so for a hollow section of outer tube and inner tube, so we need to find out what will going to be the inner diameter. So first to do that, for hollow section of outer diameter D, for hollow section of outer diameter capital D and inner diameter small d and inner diameter small d, therefore area of cross section which is A is given to be pi by 4 into capital D square minus small d square. So this is the area of cross section of a hollow tube. So wherein this D naught is nothing but capital D, and this D I is nothing but small d. So here we are subtracting the outer one with the inner one, so we are going to get the area of cross section. So now we know that what is the area of cross section which we have found out, that 8200, which will be equal to pi by 4 into capital D square is nothing but the outer diameter which is D naught, which will be equal to capital D according to the formula what we have defined here. So that will be equal to 100 square minus small d square. So therefore inner diameter D will be equal to D will be equal to 92.044 mm. So this is the value of the inner diameter. But what we want is, we want to find out what will going to be the thickness. And also he says, suggest this suitable section. Since we need to suggest the suitable thickness, so how to do that? So here, now we will want to find out the thickness of the tube in terms of T, thickness of the tube will be equal to, which is T. So how to do that? So the thickness of the tube is T, which we need to find out. So that will be equal to, so we have D, so we have capital D will be equal to D plus small t. So therefore D will be equal to D plus 2T. So we have capital D, that is the outer diameter, will be equal to inner diameter, that is D, that is this one, plus T, that is this thickness, and also plus T, that is this thickness. So that will be equal to D plus T. So that will be equal to D plus 2T. So what we want is, we want T. So we will go to take D minus D will be equal to 2T. So that what I have done is, I have transferred this to the left hand side. Therefore, T will be equal to D minus D by 2. So this is the thickness of the tube. So we are going to use this formula here. Therefore, the thickness of the tube E will be equal to capital D minus small d by 2. So that will be equal to capital D is nothing but 100 mm minus small d, which is given to be 92.044 divided by 2. So this will be 2 mm. So now this will be, therefore the thickness of the tube E will be equal to T will be equal to 3.978 mm. So now once we found out the thickness, Now we need to suggest on which category that thickness will going to fall. So it cannot be underlined because 3.5 mm is here, and but what you have got is 3.978, it is greater than that. And but in the medium it will be 4 mm, but what we found out is 3.978 mm. So this hollow tube is going to lie in the category of medium. Therefore, hence the suggested section. Hence, the suggested section. Suggested section is medium class. Is medium class. So this is how you will be able to find the solution.